एक्सजेवियन डॉक्टर विशाल सक्सेना, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन मैथमेटिक्स ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेक अ लेक्चर ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ यूलर्स थ्योरम एंड दिस थ्योरम इज अ पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर ऑफ द टॉपिक ऑफ पार्शियल डिफरेंशिएशन. As all you know that partial differentiation is a very important part of the mathematics and it is different from the ordinary differentiation. Just we can understand the partial differentiation concept by like suppose just if we have a function u and it is a function of two variables x and y. So because the function u is a function of two more than one variable, that is say x and y, so we cannot differentiate u with respect to x or y in the ordinary method, and we will differentiate the function u with respect to x or y just in the partial method, in the partial differentiation method. And when we differentiate function u with respect to x, then the other variable y is taken as constant. And if we have to find the del u on del y, means if we have to differentiate the function u with respect to y in the partial differentiation, then the first variable x is considered as a constant. So this is the basic concept of the partial differentiation. As all we know that it is an important part of the mathematical approach and the mathematical concepts, and it can be used in the various problems where the function is a function. There is a function of the there is a variable which is a function of the more than one variable, that is like the two or three or the four variables, and in that cases we have to use the concept of the partial differentiation. So in the today's lecture we are also discussing about the Euler's theorem in the partial differentiation. So first, what is Euler's theorem? We have to just see the statement. According to this theorem, if u x y be a homogeneous function of degree n, so here we are taking a function u and it is a function of more than one variable, that means it is the function u is a function of two variable x and y, and it is important thing that it is a homogeneous function. So it is a homogeneous function of two variable x and y and with degree n. So in this case, the according to Euler's theorem, x into del u by del x plus y into del u upon del y is equal to nf. So this is the statement of the theorem, and here this del is representing the notation of the partial derivative. So del by del x means the partial derivative notation here. It is just operator of partial differentiation with respect to x. And to prove this theorem, first we have to just consider a function, like we are taking a function f. It is function f is given by here, suppose like fxy, it is a function of more than one variable, that is a function f of the two variable x and y. So in this way, like we are taking like f is a function of more than one variable, that is a function of two variable x and y, and that is taken as, that is considered as x to the power n into phi y upon x. So this or therefore del f upon del x, it is del f upon del x. We have to find del f upon del x, means we have to differentiate this function f with respect to variable x. So just as we have already discussed, like we have discussed here, like when we are differentiating f with respect to x, then the other variable y is taken as constant, and when we differentiate function f with respect to y, then the variable x will be taken as constant. So here we are finding the derivative of f with respect to x, and in this way you can see this one, x is the variable and y is taken as constant. So we have to differentiate this function f. So this function f is here, because we are differentiating with respect to x, so again we can use the formula of u into v method, and first we differentiate this function x to the power n with respect to x partially, so therefore n x to the power n minus 1 and the second function phi y upon x as it is. Then we have to differentiate plus here the first function as it is x to the power n and the second function derivative. So the derivative of phi y upon x is with respect to x that is phi dash, derivative of phi is phi dash and y is constant term, so y is taken as it is here and the derivative of 1 upon x is minus 1 upon x square. So because there is minus 1 upon x square is the derivative of 1 upon x, so because here there is a negative sign, so negative into positive becomes negative and therefore this is the value of the del f upon del x and just we have seen there like it is the derivative of function f with respect to variable x. In the same way, we can differentiate the function f with respect to y partially. And when we have to differentiate this function with respect to y variable partially, so the variable x is taken as constant term, and here we can see it is x to the power n is constant term, and the derivative of f is f dash y upon x, and the derivative of y upon x will be here because we are differentiating this function with respect to y partially, so y is the variable and y, the derivative of y is 1, y the derivative of y 1 upon x is taken as constant, so it is as it is. So we are taking these equations as 1, 2 and 3 equation. So this is equation number 1, this is equation number 2 and this is equation number 3. And now as required here, x into del u by del x plus y into del u by del y is equal to n into f, or you can say like just we have to put here this equation number 2 is multiplied by x and the equation number 3 is multiplied by y, so x into del f upon del x plus y into del f upon del y is equal to, here we have taken function u or f as it is, so we can take like just nf we can say, or it is here n into u, that is n into u, or we can write x into del f upon del x plus y into del f upon del y is equal to nf or nu. So just this is the statement, so according to this we are multiplying this equation number 2 by x and we are multiplying this equation number 3 by y, 3 by y, and we are adding these two equations x into del f upon del x plus y into del f upon del y, and we are adding these two equations. So now we will get like x into del f upon del x plus y into del f upon del y, and just when we multiply this side with respect to with x, so we will get n x to the power n and phi y upon x minus x to the power just it is n minus 1 because here n minus 2 when it comes in numerator, so it becomes x to the power n minus 2 and into y, but we have multiplied here x, so it will be obtained as x to the power n minus 1 into y and then phi dash y upon x. And this equation number 3 is multiplied by y, so just when we multiply this equation by y, so it will be like x to the power n minus 1 when it comes in numerator, so x to the power n minus 1 and then y, because we have multiplied this term by y, and phi dash y upon x, so we have this equation. But we can see here these two terms like x to the power n minus 1 into y and phi dash y upon x and x to the power n minus 1 y phi dash y upon x, these two terms will cancel out because these are the same terms, so these two will be cancelled out, and what is left here we will have the term n x to the power n phi y upon x, so we will just remain this term, only this term will be remaining there, n x to the power n phi y upon x. But we can see here because we have taken this function like phi y upon x into x to the power n is equal to f, so this is our assumption, and therefore this term x to the power n into phi y upon x can be taken as f, and n is there as it is, so according to this Euler's theorem we have x into del f upon del x plus y into del f upon del y and is equal to nf, or we can say this as also because we have taken if u is a function or f is a function, if u be a function, then x into del u by del x plus y into del u by del y is equal to mu. Now, in the same way, we will take one example to explain this theorem. And according to this example, we are taking a function u. U is a function given by tan inverse x cube plus y cube upon x plus y. And now we have to prove that x into del u by del x plus y into del u by del y is equal to sine 2u with the help of Euler's theorem. So first of all, we have to understand where the Euler's theorem can be applied. So Euler's theorem can be applied where a function must be a homogeneous function. But right now, this u is equal to tan inverse x cube plus y cube upon x plus y, because it consists of the tan inverse term. Tan inverse means the trigonometric term, inverse trigonometric term. So therefore, right now it cannot be taken as a homogeneous function. But if we bring this term tan inverse in the left hand side, so it becomes tan u. So tan u is equal to, we can see here, x cube plus y cube upon x plus y. So this is the term, tan u is equal to x cube plus y cube upon x plus y. And now we can see this is just an algebraic term there. So this function is consisting of only algebraic term. So this can be taken as a homogeneous function. And why it is a homogeneous function? We have to understand this. Because this function tan u is equal to x cube plus y cube upon x plus y. It is called numerator, it is called denominator. So the numerator is a homogeneous function of degree 3. While the denominator is a homogeneous function of degree 1. We can see both are the terms, both terms are of degree 3. That's why it is a homogeneous function. And here both terms are of the degree 1. And that's why it is a homogeneous function of degree 1. It is a homogeneous function of degree 3. So ultimately, this tan u is a homogeneous function. And what will be its degree? Its degree will be here 2. Because here the numerator is of degree 3 and while the denominator is of degree 1. So ultimately it is a function of degree just 2 there. N is equal to 2. And now we consider this function as f. Suppose this function is given name f and f equal to tan u, and we can see it is a homogeneous function of degree 2. Now we can apply the Euler's theorem to prove this here, to find the desired result. So just according to Euler's theorem, x into del f upon del x plus y into del f upon del y is equal to nf. So here the function f is given by tan u. So that is tan u. So just we will put here the value of f, which is tan u. You can see there x into del upon del x in for the tan u plus y into del upon del y of tan u. This is the function f, which is here tan u, is equal to nf. N means the degree of homogeneous function, that is 2, and f means here tan u. And now just we have to find the simple differentiation, just because tan u, we are differentiating tan u function with respect to x partially, and therefore the derivative of tan u is sec square u, and the derivative of u with respect to x is del u upon del x. In the same way, plus y into sec square u del u upon del y and is equal to tan u. Now we just take common term sec square u in the left hand side, and this sec square is taken common in the left hand side, and just it is bring in the denominator in the right hand side, and you can see this one 2 tan u. Tan u means sine u upon cos u, and the sec square u term, which is in the denominator, becomes here just cos square u in the numerator. And when we simplify this term, then we will get here 2 sine u cos u, and this becomes here sine 2u. So that is the desired result, that is the required result by the Euler's theorem. And in this way, we have just found the result x into del u by del x plus y into del u by del y is equal to sine 2u. And this is a very important concept of mathematics, that is partial differentiation. And with this, I conclude my today's lecture. Thank you.